So, good afternoon, everybody. Today, I'm going to present a topic that is cyber psychology. Now, cyber psychology, as the name suggests, does include two fields, that is cyber and psychology as well. But this has been an emerging topic nowadays, and it's been there since more than two decades. So, what does cyber psychology mean? It does mean how we interact with others using technology. Now, when I read through the researches, I've gone through some individuals which stated that when they come in with touch with the technology, they suggested that everywhere I go on the internet, I keep finding myself. So this is how people connect to the technology. And it can also tell us that how we develop technology to best fit our requirements and desires. Does it also give us very innovative techniques, various solutions, and the consequences of the thinking that we are having? Now, cyber psychology also does take care upon how our behavior and the psychological states can be affected by technology. Now, during the pandemic, when I talk about, there was lots of stress during the pandemic, and the conditions were very stressful. So that obviously increases the release of hormones, and that affects the life cycles of our, and that indirectly leads to headaches and anxiety and depression and various other psychological conditions. Now, when I talk about how do a cyber psychology, when how can you know that the person has some effects of cyber psychology? So to assess that condition, we go through the eight parameters that are being stated here. That is identity, social, interactive, text or sensory, temporal, reality, and physical. These are the parameters on which we question upon that what are the social interactions you are going through, how can you reveal your identity, how you cannot reveal your identity, and in which reality you are communicating with the person through the technologies. So these parameters help us know that how the person is being in connection with the technology. So I have taken here main three fields, that is social engineering, online privacy, and cyberbullying. These three are the major fields in which we can know the effects of cyber psychology. So social engineering has namely four phases, where spear phishing is one of the major ones that social engineering has. That first the investigation is done, the phisher investigates the person, then it hooks the person, that it engage the target, and then it plays with the target. It plays that how he can expand his foothold over the target, and then it takes exit over it by removing all the data that it has been shared with the target. Online privacy also is one of the major field in the cyber psychology, where it is an interest that how the person are sharing their data, how the person are not sharing data. And it came to my notice that people are more prone to share their personal data on more informal websites rather than on the formal websites. So these how online privacies work are susceptible to a particular psychological thinking. Cyberbullying, as already we are discussing about here, cyberbullying has been a major issue where we can see people are being affected by various mental and health disorders, as they are being not giving attention, and they are also cyberbullying. They are being bullied by various means. Now, there has been also a movie where The Social Dilemma. It shows us that how the person can get affected and how the technology is being working by taking care of their mind, what the next step would be. So this all takes care into account of what are the parameters that a person is being affected by the use of cyber technologies. So after all this, I can just conclude it that we have to be prevent we have to be get ready, and since the prevention is better than cure, that we have to identify social situations around us. We have to find the malicious activity patterns that are being going on through the time. We have to take care of all the trends that are being followed, and we have to take care of the legal aspects of the things as well, and in public awareness should also be made in the people. So cybercrime is a major effect right now, and we should understand the effect of it. So thank you very much. I would be happy to receive feedback of yours.